The holidays are still months away, but if you want to make all your wishes come true for your friends and family too, now it's the time to start thinking about how you're going to pay for all of it. Steve Hoover specializes in financial planning, and he's here to tell us what you need to know. Now, a lot of people overspend on the holidays. Do we need to set up a budget now?
Any time to set up a budget is good. You want to set up a budget before you go out and start spending. So absolutely set up a budget right now, even though we're a couple of months from the holidays. At least it gives you some time to save up beforehand.
So it's all about saving, right?
Absolutely. And you should always be saving even prior to the holidays and for the holidays. I always tell my clients, save often, even not for just the holidays, but for all the time. So you want to make sure that you're maxing out your 401k, getting your match, and then also the other thing we always want people to do is put money into a Roth IRA. Great savings vehicle.
Always great advice any time of year.
Absolutely.
Okay, let's talk about the credit cards. Okay. A lot of people spend money on their credit cards and do damage to their credit scores and all of those bad things around the holidays. How do you avoid that?
Don't use them. Unless you're incredibly disciplined to pay them off when they come through in January and February, I'd advise don't use them. Use a debit card, use cash. It's going to control your spending as well. Everybody has great intentions in terms of paying off their credit card bill when it comes due in January and February. They don't, and they get on the self this wheel, and then before long, you're right back at Christmas time and you've put another $500 on it.
So you say cash.
Absolutely.
And start buying now, start shopping now, so you can kind of spread it out.
Yes, absolutely, spread it out now. The other thing that was interesting, and this we were just talking to about it before, the Wall Street Journal just had an article today about is it worth it to spend your Thursday night after Thanksgiving or Friday for Black Friday? And it was interesting in the article, they said it really doesn't. Most of the times you're not getting that great a deal by spending the night. So if you just want to avoid your family, that's fine. But you're really not going to make that much, make that big a difference in your buying.
What about shopping online? There are some great deals online that happen months out of the holidays.
Oh, absolutely. And there are other things is on buying online is that you can have them shipped directly to the store. I think some like Walmart and some of these other stores and Target will actually ship the product to the store and you just go pick it up. So it's a wonderful way to shop.
What about layaways, those Christmas clubs people talk about? Do you recommend those?
Those are good if you can do it, start it early enough. Walmart just started theirs, I believe mid-September, it goes through to mid-December. The one thing you want to watch out for are fees. You don't want to get hit with a lot of fees on that. Now Walmart charges $5, but they rebate it back to you once you've paid off your item. So they're excellent to use. It's better than using a credit card. You just have to plan a little bit and make sure you pay.
Any advice for those online retailers when you're buying that far in advance in terms of return policies?
No, they're pretty good about doing it. Some are you just know who you're dealing with. If you're dealing with the Amazons and some of those, you're going to be fine. Some of the obscure ones, you might have some problems.
Be more cautious. Okay.
Absolutely.
I love it. And also another great way to save is draw names for the holidays. And so you know you're not going to buy for 20 family members. That's one of my favorite things to do.
Right.
So then you're like, okay, I'm not going to have to spread it out.
Right.
I can just have one or two people to buy for.
Absolutely. We do that too. And set a budget of how much you can spend max. And then it just makes it a lot easier. You know who you're buying for and how much you're going to spend so you don't get out of whack. Because you get into the holiday season and you have that credit card going, it's hard to stop.
Avoid the plastic.
Absolutely.
Use your cash.
Yes,
cash. Well,
absolutely.
Great advice. Thank you so much for coming on the show. We appreciate it.
Thank you.